Ok, so I am Graziano Brasilli, a PhD student of Visual Analytics, and in particular my research is on the cybersecurity domain. I am in the Our Research Group of Professor Santucci. Today, this seminar is about part of our work on the cybersecurity domain, and in particular, visual analytics solutions for the cybersecurity domain. So today I tell you about three papers that are Vulnus, a system on vulnerability analysis, MED, a system on cyber attacks, detection and mitigation. First of all, I start with a background on cybersecurity topic. So, software vulnerability is the most important concept to understand before starting this seminar. So a software vulnerability is a weakness in the computational logic found in software or hardware components that, when exploited, result in a negative impact to confidentiality, integrity, and availability. So exploit a vulnerability means have gain some privilege on the machine, like become user or access to restricted files. Vulnerabilities can be common vulnerabilities and exposure CVE is one of the most common database of unique identifier of public known vulnerabilities. Thousands of vulnerabilities exist in this database, and it's used because they provide a unique identifier to the same problem that can spread across different operating system or hardware. This is an example of a vulnerability. CVE 2021-420-13. This is a vulnerability that affects Apache web server, in particular two version of Apache web server. And an attacker can read arbitrary files in the file system using a path traversal attack. So send a particular request to the server that allow to reach any file on the operating system. And the negative impact is that the attacker could even execute remote code on the machine. So we know this vulnerability, but how we can understand its severity? For example, with common vulnerability scoring system. The common vulnerability scoring system provides a way to capture the principal characteristics of a vulnerability by producing several numerical scores. Among the different numerical scores, now we focus on three of them. The base score that reflects the severity of a vulnerability according to its characteristics, and it's constant over the time. So the vulnerability that I previously discussed allow to execute code. So we can consider that this characteristics is very dangerous. So we can expect a high base score for that vulnerability. The exploitability score reflect how it's easy to exploit the vulnerability and can change by the time, because at the beginning a vulnerability can be difficult to exploit since require a lot of knowledge, for example, of assembly code, And after some time, maybe it's possible that an attacker create a software that do it in automatic way. So pushing a button, we can exploit a vulnerability. And this call change over the time, considering how it's easy to exploit the vulnerability now, in this moment. The environmental score instead reflects how is dangerous the vulnerability in the specific network, the environment. So if I have a vulnerability that allow to execute remote code, it's very dangerous for the machine. But if this machine is offline, so we cannot execute this code by sending GET request to the web server, for example. Or if a vulnerability can be exploited only physical, so an attacker should put an USB key in the machine to exploit the vulnerability. If we have if this machine is reachable from a physical person, the environmental score is very low. Now we start with the first prototype that I show. It's about vulnerability assessment and analysis. The application domain is a network with 22 subnetworks, 188 devices, hundreds of possible CVE for each node. In total, we have 5,000 distinct attack paths of the network. Later, I will explain what are the attack paths. And for each vulnerability, we have the base score, the exploitability score, and the environmental score. So we created a visual analytic solution that supports three main tasks: monitoring, identify areas of possible risk, identify the vulnerability status of the network, and identify nodes that require detailed analysis. For example, nodes that has a lot of vulnerabilities, or maybe not so much vulnerabilities, but with high score, and so on. The other task is analysis that can be node-driven or vulnerability-driven. And in the end, the what-if analysis that supports the exploration and decision of fixing plan. So we start to think about how to represent the network. A classic solution to represent the network is the node link diagram. But in this particular solution, we want to focus on vulnerabilities and not on the topological structure of the network. So we have to think to another solution. A possible approach is to use a tree map. So a tree map is able to represent a hierarchical structure, so the network, in a compact way and provide inner space to represent related information. The tree map is composed of nested rectangles, and their area and colors can be used as visual variables. So we start with a simple tree map with each element with the same size. So how can I highlight the nodes having a high number of vulnerabilities? So we can use the area. In this way, it's easy to find elements, nodes that have a high number of vulnerabilities because they are the biggest one. The second task is how to encode environmental score of the vulnerabilities of the node. We can use the color, so we compute the average environmental score for all the vulnerabilities of the node and code using a color scale. In this example, is a red color scale from white that means zero and red that means 10 that is a maximum environmental score. But we have two other metrics that have to consider, exploitability and base score. We decide to create a glyph inside each node. So the exploitability is shown as a stacked bar chart, horizontal stacked bar chart here, in which we group the score in 5 interval from lower to higher, and the length is proportional to the number of vulnerabilities having that score. So for example, the black one is about 20% of the total length. So meaning that 20% of the vulnerabilities have a score that is 10, since it's black. White means zero. The environmental score is encoded as the red color from white to red, dark red, while the base score is the 8th of this rectangle. So an height by score means that we have the red part that cover all the nodes. So the blue is the background and disappear when the base score become higher. In this particular example, we have different information encodes in a particular in a rectangle. So we create a new encoding for this task. This is a screenshot from the system. So we have different nodes with different sides. So this one is bigger, is the biggest one, but its environmental score is white. So it's not dangerous for the environmental, for the network that I have. Instead, this one is smaller, but the environmental score is very high. So probably an expert should consider first this one instead of this. Okay, some numbers, 61 vulnerabilities, environmental score 0, half covered, base score 5. Small area, low number, 2 vulnerabilities, environmental score 5.2, base score 10, since it's full covered, there is no blue background. 2 vulnerabilities again, environmental score 10, base score 8.4. Now we have to think how to encode a subnetwork. So a subnetwork is a collection of nodes. And we have 256 subnetwork and nodes in a subnetwork. So we decide to create a double encode. Nodes without vulnerabilities are encoded on the left in a square matrix. And they are small and blue, meaning that they are safe from vulnerabilities. Then we have the remaining part, that is a tree map, which the total length of the tree map is proportional to the total number of vulnerabilities of the subnetwork. And then inside there is a tree map with the same encoding that I show you. Nodes with zero CVE on the left. Source node, so source of the attack, are highlighted with a different color. In this case, a light chan mark. A yellow mark encodes the target node of an attack. And this is the example that I showed previously. So little number of CV, high number of vulnerabilities. Now we have to think to how to encode all the subnetworks. So we have a bar chart, an horizontal bar chart, in which each bar is a subnetwork. And the length is proportional to the total number of vulnerabilities of the subnetwork. And this solution can maintain the proportion of area among different nodes. So these nodes here have the same as the same number of vulnerabilities of this node here, because the area is equal. And this approach is an enhanced bar chart or an enhanced tree map using a tree map bar chart. Now I will show you a live demo of the prototype that you can reach on this website. One moment. Okay. This is the system. We have an overview here, which show all the subnetwork with a focus plus context technique. The visible part here is highlighted with a blue rectangle. And I can scroll like this, or I can scroll here. Subnetworks are ordered by the number, total number of vulnerabilities. So the first one that I have to look is the topmost one, since the subnetwork has a lot of, is the biggest subnetwork in terms of vulnerabilities. While at the end, we have subnetworks with no vulnerabilities. I can select nodes or even all the subnetwork. When I select elements, in the bottom part, I have details on the selection. So here I have a frequency plot of vulnerabilities of the subnetwork. When I select a bar that is a vulnerability, I can inspect the score of the vulnerabilities in a radar chart. And I can compare multiple vulnerabilities here, the orange one and the red, and then the green one. In addition, I can look at the distribution of the world vulnerability, all the vulnerabilities of the network for each metrics using a box plot. Here, just a moment. Okay. So I can filter vulnerabilities by score, selecting intervals or selecting uniform interval or distribution interval given by a box plot. Can select this part, meaning that I select the from lower quartile to the median. The same thing is possible to do on the nodes. So I can select nodes with having vulnerabilities with high exploitability and high environmental, for example. And multiple selection are allowed. In addition, I can also select nodes by types, all the source nodes, all the target nodes. And of course, the selection here updates the selection in this part of the system. This is the vulnerability, the nodes driven analysis. Instead, we can change the analysis considering other tasks. So here the encoding is different. So this is the vulnerability driven analysis in which there is one unique tree map encoding all nodes. The area of the nodes is proportional to the number of, each element is a vulnerability. Now, the area is the number of nodes having that vulnerability. So this node here, it is big, means that this vulnerability 040185 share is on, I cannot read the tooltip. So it's on many devices. Instead, this one that has an highest environmental score, since it's red, is on two devices, number of IP, two. This is a different analysis driven by vulnerabilities. Instead, I can conduct an analysis driven by score. In this case, each bar is a group of score for vulnerabilities. And the nodes are represented at the leaf, at the tree map. So we have all the nodes having a vulnerability, a base score in the range 9.5, 10, and so on. Another analysis is the network, in which we have the overview of all the network, in which node leaf of the tree map are the subnet now. So the information of exploitability, environmental, and base score is aggregated of the considering the average of the node of the subnetwork. Now, okay. I will discuss the other task, that is the what if analysis. So the what if analysis should support the exploration and decision of fixing plans. First, I have to introduce some background about attack paths. A single step attack paths means that an attacker start from a source node A, exploit CV number one, that is on node B, and then as a consequence, breach privileges on the node B, depending of the CVE that allow to do. The assumption is that the source is already under the control of the attacker. Since we are in the cybersecurity domain, the worst scenario has been always to consider it. And so what happened that the attacker exploit a CVE here and do a single step attack. Instead, it's possible also to have a multi-step attacks in which the attacker start to exploit a vulnerability. This is the source, start to exploit a vulnerability here, and then pass to other nodes, and so on, creating a chain of exploits that is a multi-step attack path. So it starts from the source and reach the target of the attack. The multi-step attacks is common when an attacker wants to reach a critical machine like a server, and that is protected and not always exposed to the internet. So for example, if we consider a company having a web server, this one that is exposed on the internet connected to another machine that have a database, from this web server that is exposed, the attacker can exploit another vulnerability on the database and then move to other nodes of the network until reaching a critical node like another server and so on. After that, we have to introduce the attack graph environmental score. It's a different concept of environmental score, which the dangerousness of the vulnerabilities is considering the attack graph, in particular the attack paths. So vulnerabilities that are involved in attack paths to target nodes have high attack graph environmental score. Instead, vulnerabilities that are not involved in attack paths to target nodes have a low attack graph environmental score, meaning that if I attack the node C that is not a target, this is not dangerous for my organization. Since, for example, we can suppose the node C is the coffee machine. And this case, CV1 and 4 are the one used to reach the target node. So their environmental score should be higher than these two here. After introducing the attack graph environmental score, we can think to the optimal fixing strategy. Means that the optimal strategy is to remove the smallest number of vulnerabilities that allow to block all the attack paths to the target nodes on the network. An attack path is blocked if cannot reach a target node. So in this case, here, it's simple. We should remove these two vulnerabilities and the attacker cannot reach the two target nodes. The problem can be modeled as a set cover problem that is NP complete. So our solution is to use the predict set cover algorithm that creates an approximated optimal fixing strategy. Now I will show the second part of the demo. Okay. Here on the right, we have a list of vulnerabilities ordered by environmental score and the higher environmental score, meaning that the attack graph environmental score. The first suggested patch, that is CVE on a particular CVE on an host, in this case, this one that can be highlighted with a mouse over on this element, or for example this one. This vulnerability, that is the first proposed by the strategy, is the vulnerabilities that involve the most number of the high number of attack paths to all the target nodes. So this system allows to do a what if analysis, meaning that I can simulate the fix of some vulnerabilities and look at the result. So in this case, I can mitigate these vulnerabilities that is here, and the system recompute all the metrics and the attack graph. Now we have pruned from the attack graph 30% of the attack paths. So attack paths 70% means that 70% of the original number. The arrow that blink means that in this node the environmental score with the patch that we have applied is decreased. Instead, on some nodes, like this, there is no arrow, meaning that this fix does not affect these nodes. I can fix another vulnerability. Okay, the effect is not visible now. What we can do is to revert also fix and try different combination. Each time I select a fix, the algorithm, the system recompute the suggestion using this grid set cover algorithm. So this second fix now is proposed as the first mitigation to apply, but if I apply this, it's possible that this one can be not useful and the system propose another patch. This strategy to try a fix and revert is common in a critical environment when applying a fix mean to change version of some particular software that maybe it's impossible to do in a quick way since a lot of other of services rely on this software, like sync to operating system version. Before changing the operating system version, we have to move and to check if it's possible to use other software or the software that we are still using in the new version operating system. So the what if analysis allow to try different solution or mitigation in order to block all the number of attack paths. In this case, with only seven fix, so seven vulnerabilities that I can remove from nodes, I can block all the attack paths of the network. So with four fix, we have only 22% of paths remaining. Starting from hundreds of vulnerabilities is a good approach to use this plan. Okay, now we change topic. Okay. The second system. That I propose just a moment. I have some problem with PowerPoint and the monitor. Okay. I think you now can see the slide. Okay, so the second topic is proactive and reactive analysis of cyber attacks. The scenario and the background is the same of vulnerability analysis, but in this case, we want to analyze attack paths and possible evolution of attacks. We have developed MED, a visual analytic solution that supports three main tasks. Proactive analysis of possible attack paths, meaning that a security operator can analyze all the possible risks that, that they have in the network. Then the MED supports the detection of ongoing attacks and show the possible evolution. And then it proposes strategies to blocking or mitigating the incoming threats. The problem to address with this solution is the high number of attack paths to represent. This is a simple scenario with six nodes and some vulnerabilities that can be exploited on them. This is the attack graph, the union of all the attack paths on the node, on the network. In this example, I have these attack paths from source to target. I have these attack paths that reach the same target. And in total, I can have 99 different attack paths on this small example. The problem is that in a real scenario, we can have thousands of millions of distinct attack paths at various length if we have different targets. So we start by representing the network topology as a node diagram, since we want to focus on the topology. The problem is that the green number of attack paths create overlapping problems. And then an approach is to filter attack paths by different characteristics. But an overview of all the attack paths should be always provided. So we start with a knife attack graph representation with the topology as a knotlink diagram. And then we plot the attack paths as red line over the nodes. So if I have an attack path A, B, and C, we draw a red line between A and B and B and C. The problem is that there is an overplotting. Another possible solution, and we can add information about source and targets on the network. So we can add a label S and T over the nodes. In this way, we can easily find the source and targets. Then we can use the size of elements to represent the path cardinality. Node radius depends on the number of attack paths that traverse them. And the edge thickness depends on the number of attack paths that traverse the edge between these two nodes. This solution has to identify most involved nodes in the attack. Then we can think to the roles that the nodes have in attack paths. So this is an attack path in which we have a source, some middle nodes, and a target. We identify the nodes with three different colors, green, blue, and red, source, middle, and target step. Then, so we plot on a node a pie chart showing the proportion of these attack paths. In this case, 20% are final attacks that reach the target, and 80% are middle step. So this is a complex encoding that show different information like cardinality of attack paths, role of attack paths, and role of nodes on the network. Another requirement when dealing with the cybersecurity domain is that the current coding should fit cybersecurity common uses. So we cannot use the color that we like for particular information. For example, red is associated to risk in cybersecurity, and green or blue in general is to something that is safe. So we change the encoding, the knife encoding, to a complex encoding with different color that is from a yellow-red scale. In this case, final step is still red, and the other step are yellow and orange. Then we have to show the type of the device of the network, like if it's a server, if the device is a laptop, and so on. And we use a little icon inside the nodes. We have to show information about how many vulnerabilities has been exploited or are possible to exploit. Since we are in the proactive scenario, we are analyzing all the possible evolution of attacks. In this case, we use a Dana chart that is a the gray ring around the nodes. I have a different slide for this. Okay, the path proportion become an internal Dana chart since we have to make room for the icon. Then the background of the nodes encodes the privilege reached by the attacker, the maximum privilege. So if a vulnerability can allow to become root of the system, we can easily understand this fact. And in this case, we use three different colors, meaning non-user or root of the operating system. Then the number of vulnerabilities exploited on the nodes. The gray ring show all the vulnerabilities that can be exploited with respect to the total number of the vulnerabilities of the node. In this case, about 25%. And then the blue is a subset of the gray one, meaning that some vulnerabilities allow to perform an internal escalation. Internal escalation is when I start an attack without privileges on the machine, and exploiting different vulnerabilities, I can gain my privileges, become user of the system until become the root of the system. And privilege escalation attacks are difficult to discover since they do not produce network traffic. So the attacker remain inside the same machine without sending packets to other machine and so on. So in general, system that analyze the network traffic to discover if a possible attack if there is an attack, look to the network traffic. And when an attack or part of this attack is an internal escalation attack, there is no network traffic. So the intrusion detection system that we have is possible that cannot find this type of attack. This is the new encoding. For the moment, do not consider the map that is behind. So look only to the nodes. We have different icons, meaning that we have different type of nodes, a server, a laptop, different number of vulnerabilities exploited. This one is a gray ring that covers 80%. So 80% of these nodes can be exploited. Okay. Then we want to filter attack paths according to different dimension. We use a parallel coordinates plot. Axis are characteristics dimension of the path. For example, length, likelihood, impact, risk. Likelihood is can be considered as the probability of that an attacker can use this attack path. Impact depends on the score of the vulnerabilities and the privileges gained during this attack. And the risk depends on business metrics, like if an attacker attack the coffee machine, the risk for the company can be known. Instead, if the attacks go to a critical server, the risk can be high. In general, risk, in this case, risk is likelihood multiplied by impact. And it's possible to filter on the axis and the attack graph updates according to what we filter here. Another problem that we have is that we have a lot of information encoded on the topology. And we have problem of cluttering renderings. A lot of information can be plotted one up over the other. And we have to think to a different solution to mitigate this issue. So we use a semantic topology aggregation method. So we aggregate nodes in clusters, considering the geography, the topology, and the business. And the cluster of nodes maintain the same encoding of devices, but show the average or the global metrics for all the nodes, like the cardinality of attack paths that involve this cluster of nodes is shown here as the sum of all the attack paths that pass through these nodes. And we have to think to this type of aggregation since standard solution that exists for cluttering problem cannot be applied a standard solution in sampling. So we cannot show everything since we have millions of attack paths. We can show some of them to that represent the whole set. In cybersecurity, it's not possible this approach since each attack path is important. And a security operator should be aware of each single attack path since an attacker can use it. And then we plot a map behind the topology. In this case, this network is spread over different countries. And the problem to address is to minimize the difference between the topology and geography, since this is a cluster which is located on the map. When we open a cluster, like here, the nodes can cover a wide part of the map. In this case, the meaning the is not the same of this. So there is no meaning of depending on the position of this node. That's why we added a convex hull, a black convex hull that covered the map, meaning that here the position are not relevant. And so this problem can be resolved with this solution, for example. Now I have a video on the system. On this system. Okay, so this is the scenario that I explained. We have clusters of device. In this case, we have attack paths that involve only these two clusters. The user can inspect and open clusters to see the nodes. Can brush, okay, here. Here we see different color of the ground. This is a cluster with the world, but this is a node that is gray. The background is gray, meaning that the user cannot reach privileges on this machine. Instead, blue means that user reach the user privilege, the attacker reach the user privilege on the machine. And red, that in this case is not visible, mean that the user reach the attacker reach the root privileges. Here we have the source of the attack, since we can filter by source, and the user select just a moment. Okay. Filter. on source, highlight the filter, highlight the attack path, involve that start from this source, and we have an alpha blending or the attack paths that are not considered. Then we have a mitigation list that uses the same strategy of Vulmus that I show to you. So we have a list of device and possible vulnerabilities to mitigate. In this case, we have two strategies. Mitigate all vulnerabilities of a device, and we have a plan that order devices according to that. Or we have the strategy of Vulmus, in which we have a vulnerability and a device failure. So in this case, now the system are recomputing the attack graph. Okay. So the result is that some attack paths has been prone. Then we can filter on length of attack paths, meaning that the attack graph is recomputed filtering out attack path having a length greater than 2. The mitigation table changes since the attack paths changed. Then we can filter by length or other metrics, highlighting sorts or adding or removing sorts in this proactive analysis. So the proactive analysis allow the operator to add and test different sorts of attacks. In this case, with just one source, we can see that the attack remains inside the cluster. We can select it as a target, so we are filtering all the paths that go to this node, and so on. Each interaction on the left has an effect on the right has an effect here on the attack graph. So this is a complex solution with multiple coordinates view that allow the operator, the security operator, to explore and analyze all the possible attack paths of the network. Okay, my presentation is finished. And of course, we are working on different topics, not only these two. For example, we have an evolution of MED that consider business constraints on while applying mitigation and the role that attack paths have in the graph, in the network, depends on the business constraint of the company. So if we have a service that is replicated on a different device, an attack path that reach all device altogether can be very dangerous, since with this attack the service can be broken. So this is another topic in which we make research, and always on cybersecurity. I finish, and if you have question, can you write on the chat? I remember to you that at 1:30 there is lecture with Marco Angelini. Okay. I think we can close here.
Yes, Graziano, thank you for your presentation.